single mother at 29, two young boys to support, rent, bills, debts to pay, no money coming in. It's 1791, and she reinvents herself. This is the story of courage. This is the story of Constanze, Mozart's wife. Salzburg, birthplace of Mozart, mecca for musicians, and booming business trade for exploiters of the Mozart brand. Final resting place too for Constanze, Mozart's liebstes, bestes Weibchen, his dear little wife. Many of Mozart's biographers have been really rather rude about Constanze, some even saying that she was unworthy of his love. But if one goes directly to the source, to the documents of the time, to the diaries, to the anecdotes, just to the basic facts, a very different lady comes to the surface. We see a girl who is initially overshadowed by her very talented older sisters, but who quietly gains confidence. And when Mozart dies and she has to repay debts, she organizes concerts around Germany. She fights for justice with publishers, and she has this inner driver, this engine, in order to keep the spirit of Mozart alive for posterity. What I see is a lady who's independent before her time, who's wise beyond her limited education, and who turns herself into one of the most business-savvy ladies of the 19th century. Is this the same lady about whom one biographer could write, "In nothing could Mozart really rely upon Constanze"? I'm on a mission to discover the real Constanze, before, during, and after her life with Mozart.